Warning. Warning.
This show contains mature content. Listener discretion is advised.
Are you ready to get your mind blown?
What are you? Who are you?
This is the Crotch Shot Radio Show. Crotch Shot Radio Show.
This is not a test. This is a broadcast transmission.
We're going to stay on the air.
And now, the weepy. The weepy.
Yo, welcome to the Crotch Shot Radio Show, where we kick the issues in the balls. We are on an active war against bullshit. We would do anything and everything to expose bullshit. The ends sometimes justify the means. So if you're angry and want the truth exposed, then strap in and prepare to be shocked. This is Smash Mouth Talk. If you can't accept that, then fuck off. I'm your host, Louis B. I takes no shits from nobodies, but I do deliver a healthy dose of true shit to you. Today will not be any different. I still got the sniffles. But before, let's hit the background music. There we go. This is something that's been gnawing at me. It was gnawing at me the whole day. I'd say 2 years, have been active in the men's rights movement, have exposed many inconsistencies when it comes to feminism. In fact, I've personally been affected by radical feminist beliefs, been accused of being a rapist, and to the point where it got me hating women. It got me looking at every chick, wishing them, hopefully, you know, going around saying, oh God, I hope she gets raped so that way she knows what it really feels like. Like, that anger. And it wasn't getting me anywhere. It wasn't. I had to stop. I had to stop, pull back. Excuse me. I had to pull back and look and examine myself because, you know, what was I getting? Nothing. Especially when my own personal desire, my own DNA, my nature had what was overriding what I really wanted to do, what I really wanted out of life, and it was basically to share my life with that special girl. And I realized I wasn't doing myself any favors. Let's even put the part that I want a relationship, because that's not the point that I wanted to make. It wasn't making me into the man I want to be. Someone who, you know, yes, I'm a fighter, but I fight because I give a shit. And it got me hating life itself. Because I was hating women. I was hating... I felt myself even talking like a radical feminist. Like, with that hate and bigotry. And the fact that I just, you know... I had to slow myself down because I'm like, wait a minute. I have a mother. I have a grandmother. I have a sister. I have female family members. I have female friends who are close and who have done stuff for me and have helped me and have loved me. I had to put that in perspective. Even recently, you know, a cousin, you know, she's young. She disrespected me. I felt slighted. And I just had to let that go recently after I got out of the hospital and realized I could have died and, you know, she could have gone through life thinking that I died hating her. And it's not something I want. I don't want that. And, you know, I have to, like, I don't want to say bash, but, you know, I have to point out some things because there are a couple friends, and I still do consider them friends, that have, you know, posted stuff on Facebook on how they hate women and how, you know, how they're, you know, how all women are bad. And I know they started attacking that, you know, narwhals, like not all women are like that. But it's true. Not all women are like that. In fact, there are certain women condemning feminism. And, I mean, just going off this blanket statement that all women are evil and inherently evil is just lazy. And you're not going to attack the real issue. You don't, you know, you're afraid of getting married, then don't get married. If you don't want certain things to happen, then there are ways to prevent them. You know, it's like, if you don't, like me, I don't want to have kids. I'm going to do something about that. I'm trying to improve my own situation because most of the, like, let's just be honest. Most of the reason why I catch hell is because I'm trying to find someone to accept me when I don't accept myself. I mean, I'm at a level where I wouldn't date me if I was a chick. And why is that? I have to make certain improvements. And, you know, and I put out that energy. And of course, look, I'm not saying they're, you know, there are bitches out there. I, you know, that's why I stopped internet, you know, freaking, I took off, you know, Plenty of Fish, OkCupid, and other dating sites because, you know, they are mean chicks out there that will talk to you like you're the inventor of rape. That's the part I hate when it comes to radical, some women are like that. But as I discussed, you know, my last show, the easiest way to do is just have no dealings with those certain people. And that should go with the MRA should start doing that. It's you know what? Okay, you like that? I refuse to speak with you. Because when it comes to radical feminists like Chanty Binks, you could Google her and see her. She will not be reasoned with. People that have that doctrine, like, in them, they cannot be reasoned with, no matter how much logical, information you provide. They will just see you as the enemy. And honestly, I'm not, like, look, I'm not gonna go and start, you know, being a white knight and defending women, you know, to the point it's like, oh, well, you know, you should talk to her because she's a lady. You know, I'm not going to be a thirsty simp. No. I'm just not going to join in their shenanigans. I mean, I'm going to expose stuff like stupid slogans like only men could stop gender violence and rape. When there are articles where you see, you know, women actually assisting in a rape. In fact, I just read a news article today where a 16-year-old girl was raped, being helped by female bullies holding her down so she could be raped. I still do not believe that there's such a thing as a rape culture, because rape is, to any normal, sane human being, it's repugnant. It's horrible. It shouldn't happen. It shouldn't exist. And look, I know you're going to look at... And I'm going to keep those shows up because I'm fucking transparent. A lot of things I've said in the past, I've said out of anger and hurt and pain. That's not the person I want to be. And saying, oh, women are this, oh, women are that, just lazy. But I understand where that's coming from because I was there. And, you know, I quit all my MRA, all the MRA groups. It wasn't serving me. It wasn't turning me into the man I want to be. In fact, it was making me angry, more frustrated, less hopeful. I believe she's out there. I know what I want. I know what I won't put up with. I want respect. I want affection. And if that person that I meet does not meet my qualifications, my standards, I will not fight. I will just move on. And that's what we should do, is just like, okay, let's attack the problem. Because, like, you know, with paternity fraud, with false rape allegations, attack the issue. Because you're not going to convert them. You're not going to convert someone that's really... you know, who really hates men. It's a waste of time to even engage them. And feminist, okay. I want to talk to you. I'm not going to apologize for what another man did. If you were raped, truly raped... because, unfortunately, people lie. And unfortunately, justice is blind. Which means, if there's no evidence... excuse me. And they couldn't get your rapist convicted... I don't know what to tell you. Shit happens. Bad people get away with doing bad things. That is the nature of our legal system. Sometimes it works. Sometimes it doesn't. Yesterday, I signed a petition to get a girl who's in jail for life. She was convicted at 16 for... killing her John. This girl was abused. She was, she was human trafficked and forced into prostitution. Her whole mental state was messed up. I feel bad for her. Should she do some time? Yes. She murdered somebody. Should she be in jail forever? No. But at the same point, I find a man who was paying his child support and taking care of his son being sentenced to 6 months equally as repugnant, equally as disgusting. A wise friend once told me, screw it, I'll tell you her name, Christy Aphrodite. It's not either or. It's both and more. And I never really paid attention and tried to understand what that meant. Bullshit happens on both sides. And she told me, you know, she also told me about this finger pointing. It's his fault, it's his fault, it's his fault, it's his fault. And it's the same shit that you see on Fox News against MSNBC. All this finger pointing. Oh, the Democrats do this and the Republicans do that and they're destroying this country because this and that. MRAs are like, feminists do this. And feminists are like, MRAs are this and that and the other thing. Men are this and women are that. You're not solving shit. You're not fixing the real issue. All you're doing is alienating each other. And I know a friend of mine is going to say you're acting like Gandhi, this Buddhist bullshit, but just be like, look a feminist in the eye, look a MRA, I'm not the enemy. I would never rape. I will never hurt. But I refuse to answer for retards that pull stupid shit. Let's find a solution instead of finger pointing each other and fix the issue. And I know this is a complete 180 to how I've been talking for a very long time, but I was getting myself sick. All this hate was getting bunched up in my chest and it wasn't getting me anywhere. And it's not going to get you anywhere. It's not. And I wasn't. And it wasn't making. And there was really no incentive for me to heal myself. You know, I'm trying. But it's like, you know, when you're told you're scum, you're not worthy, you're not this, you're not that, because you don't have this, that, the other thing, or you don't look like this. The pressure, and when you can't achieve that ideal, it turns to hate. I mean, I renounce MRA groups, but I'm not gonna renounce all the beliefs, all the issues, the real problems. You know, I'm willing to take on the real issues. And I've been asked, what are you doing, like by feminists, what are you doing to try to prevent rape or try to help that? Unfortunately, I can't really, you know what, I'm doing something against internet predators. That's all I'm gonna say, because you know I work with a couple guys and I don't want to spill the beans too much, but I'm doing something. But, you know, I'm not just trying to focus on, oh, men do this, men do that. Honestly, male predators know what they're doing is wrong. They just don't give a shit. Because they're insane. That is the difference. That is why I don't feel like I have, you know, I'm not part of gender violence, because I've never raped, because I know it's wrong and I know it's stupid. I know, and it's not in me to do it. but you know, it's you know, this has just been, I mean, this is probably going to be another quick hit. I'm not going to go a whole hour, but you know, it's just this is something that's been gnawing at me this whole day. It's like, okay, how can we fix this? Well, let's stop this whole fucking finger pointing shit. That's one way. Let's get down to brass tacks. What are the real issues? What issues do women have? Okay, do they feel like they're, you know, they're not getting paid the same? Which, hey, not necessarily true anymore. You want to be an astronaut? Well, there are women that have been astronauts. I mean, I'm sorry, this is America. Nothing is just fucking handed to you. That male privilege that feminists love to talk about comes with male responsibility. It comes with not being held accountable for every fucking thing. And having to deal with the consequences. You want that? Then you can't get the same consideration and the courtesies that you get being a woman. You have to, you know, you roll up your sleeves, Ruby the Riveter. Get to work. And deal with the consequences. Deal with all the... You saved my life tonight, then left for pouring rain. My life tonight. Love that song. Cruella Legacy. I'm just love that shit. So anyways, you show me how to feel again. Yeah, that's another thing. I try to suppress my emotions. I tried to the only emotion that I was allowing was hate. And it doesn't feel good. It really doesn't. All this anger and rage. I'm not saying it doesn't have a place, because it does. And, you know, I just, I couldn't. But, you know, like, again, I'm not gonna be a white knight. I'm not gonna coddle. But, you know, I'm not gonna freaking be spreading fucking rage and hate, because I can't. I just can't. It doesn't seem right. It doesn't make sense for me to do that. Especially when both sides pull some dumb shit. They do. And you know, and for those of you that know me, that have listened to this show, I'm all about cleaning up my own fucking house and taking my own fucking inventory. That's why I went after Luke. You know, head of We Are Change. You know, for stealing money. You know, 9/11 Truth Group. Because, you know, it felt stupid that, you know, we freaking preach against the New World Order and various, political entities to steal money and do criminal shit, and yet allow it in our own fucking house. And yeah, I went through hell when I did that. So the thing is, how can I be against radical feminism and how some women are just bigots. And then just co-sign that same type of behavior. Again, I'm like, look, I understand that rage. And I know it's coming from anger and hate and rage. I can't be a part of that anymore. I needed to heal my own self. I needed to freaking rescue my own soul from the fucking abyss, because I was slipping. And the last time I allowed myself to fall so hard, I was in a goddamn coma for fucking pneumonia. And I almost died. And I made a promise that I would never go there ever again. I can't. Because I'm pretty sure if I ever allow myself to slip and get that sick again, I ain't coming back. It's just... I mean, and please forgive me for those of you that go through this, but it felt like my hate and rage, like, look, I'm just going to say this. I don't fully understand addiction. I know I've asked questions about it and how it really feels, because I've never snorted cocaine. I've never did drugs. I smoke weed only twice. Which, you know, I don't think that counts as drugs. But other than that, my anger and rage were affecting my life. Affecting my personal relationships. Affecting my work. So, I mean, I would say hate and anger on my drug. It just didn't feel good. It wasn't. I couldn't do it. Can't do it. I need to reach my own evolution. I need to evolve. Jettisoning all the dead weight that doesn't serve me anymore. And I just, you know, and the reason why I'm saying this, I'm getting personal, is like, maybe you out there, whoever listens to this, needs to do that. And understand. And me, I mean, I'm not saying I got all the answers, because I don't. I'm trying to figure it out. And I'm just freaking putting it out there in the hopes that this will actually help people. Because you know what? Yeah, this show's called the Crotch Out Radio Show. Because I attack society's bullshit. But sometimes I gotta attack my own bullshit. And if anybody's dealing with the same bullshit, you gotta kick that shit in the nuts. So anyways, thanks for listening. I actually wanted to give a big shout out. excuse me, damn. Oh man. Wanted to give a big shout out to a few guys that commented on my last show. Feel free and listen to it. I have it on YouTube. This show will be going on YouTube. Just feel free. Follow me on Twitter. LouisB1. At LouisB1 on Twitter. You can follow me on... also Instagram. Yeah, I got Instagram. You can go to RantingLouisB.blogspot.com. For all that loveliness, feel free, hit up my Amazon link there. Yeah, like to again, let me give a big shout out. I'm trying to find it. Yes. My show, big shout out to the 5x5. He commented, check out his show on Spreaker, the 5x5. And Guy Shea, check him out on Spreaker. In fact, hold on, and News Guy, check him out. In fact, go check out Spreaker, that's with a R, /user/ the 5x5 with numbers. Also, News Guy. Just News Guy 2005 on Spreaker. And Guy Shea, like spelled like Shea Stadium. I'm trying to hold back a cough like a motherfucker right now. Sorry. Check them out. Spreaker.com/user/3603922. Or, you know, or follow him on Twitter at WhatTheGuyShea. So definitely check him out. So, oh man. Also, big shout out. Shout out to everyone that follows me on Spreaker. So, feel free to listen and share. So, like to thank everyone for listening. This has been the Crotch Shot Radio Show. And I've been your host, Louis B. Thanks for listening. From my house to your house. Mahalo.
That's the edge of my show. Donk.